What up guys, it's your boy That's It Zach, and like I said, we are going to talk about how to calculate your calories for mass gain, fat loss, or maintenance. I'm gonna break it down for you. This is from my 8-week cut video that I told you guys to come here and see how I did it, how I do my calculations, so that you guys can set your goals and choose what you wanna do, gain muscle, get skinny, I'm not skinny anymore, but or maintain your weight, all right? So we're gonna jump into it right about now, but before we go, don't forget to click that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you guys know when these videos are coming out, because there's a lot coming out. So let's jump right into it now. Made a little list here for you guys, okay? I don't know if you see it. I'm gonna flip the camera around so you guys can see it, but we're gonna talk about the steps that I do, because again, it's all about calculations and writing it down so you guys know the plan and for you to set it. So step one is your BMR, okay? So your BMR is your basal metabolic rate. That's how much your body will burn on you doing pretty much nothing at all. If you were to lay in bed and just sleep all day, this is how much your body needs to function, your organs, your brain, everything. All right, so the way to calculate this, this is what I like to use, it's the Harris-Benedict equation. Okay, so it's pretty much, I'm gonna show you guys the numbers. So it's different for men and women, but at the end, all you gotta do is put your weight in kilograms, your height in centimeters, and your age. Then from there, you're gonna get a number. That number is your BMR, all right? From your BMR, you're gonna multiply that by an activity level range. That being said, there's 5 different ranges. There's little to no exercise, all right? That, you're gonna take your BMR, you're gonna times it by 1.2, all right? If you do light exercise a few times a week, okay, so this is anywhere, let's say between 40 to 60%, a few times a week. This is like ADLs, activities of daily living. This is more like walking, walking your dog, a little bit of light yoga, nothing very heavy. If you do that a few times a week, you're gonna multiply your BMR by 1.375. If you do moderate exercise, so now we're getting into a little bit more of the intensity ranges, 3 to 5 times a week, you're gonna multiply that number by 1.55. If you do a lot of heavy training a week, so we're talking about every single day, we've got some intense training going on, you're gonna multiply that number by 1.725. And if you're an athlete, yes, an athlete, you know, multiply your number by 1.9, and that's because you're training 7 days a week or more. So like I said before, I train roughly 2 times a day, every day, 7 days a week. That's the number I use. And again, it will vary depending on the person to person. You might need a little more, a little less, depending on your goal. Right? Once you have that activity number, that is your total daily expenditure number. So that's how much you need to stay the weight that you're at, right? So if that's your goal, that's how much you're gonna eat. But now if you wanna gain more muscle, or if you wanna lose more fat and keep on the muscle, we're gonna go to the next step, right? So the next step is how to set your calories. Now, for a mass gain protocol, people really overdo the protein, and it's actually shown to fuck your shit up. So we don't want that. So if you're trying to gain muscle mass, at the end of the day, you just wanna be in a positive nitrogen balance state. That number typically is from 0.7 to 0.8 times your weight, okay? So I weigh right now 212. So if I multiply that by 0.7 to 0.8, I'm hovering around 170 grams of protein a day. I typically don't go higher than 150 grams a day, and I'm saying the numbers, again, like I said, they always vary, so try it out. I found anywhere between 100 to 150 is fine with me, and I gain muscle mass and I'm okay. So that's how much I like to stick to. And again, it turns out to be less than 20% of your total caloric needs. Now, if you wanna lose, you wanna be in a caloric deficit. So you wanna be burning more than you're taking in. So remember we talked about that number right there? So you would roughly take away some of the calories, and then you wanna maintain your muscle mass. So we don't wanna lose any muscle mass, but we wanna keep what we have while burning fat. So that number is usually 1.64 or 1.6, again, depending on the person. So you multiply your weight by 1.6, that's how much protein you'll be eating. And then for the rest of the calories, which is carbs and fat, you'll be able to split up on whatever type of diet you like to follow, but that's gonna be the next step, all right? So that's how to find out your calories. If you wanna maintain, it'll be the same as losing. Again, we're not trying to gain muscle, we're not trying to lose muscle. I said lose muscle. not trying to lose muscle, all right? So if we're not trying to lose muscle or gain muscle, again, we'll go on that straight number there, 0.64, 0.6, pretty much good to go. Now, to find what works for you is step four, honestly, and those are the ratios. So fat and carbs, again, people work well on a keto diet, people work well on a high carb diet, people work well on a well-balanced diet. Again, this video is not to tell you what's good, what's bad, it's just to tell you how to do it. So at the end of the day, you get to choose your carbs and fat ratios. I think that you should keep your fats. Right now I'm experimenting with a higher fat diet. In the past I've done a higher carb diet and I just wanna see how it's going. My last camp, it worked perfectly on a higher fat diet, but I'm not a very strong proponent on keto diet, especially for a sport that's more glycolytic based, boxing, sprinting, anything like that, marathon running and all those types of things, and triathletes and triathlons, a higher fat diet does make sense, but pure keto I think is completely idiotic. And I also think that people on a keto diet still need to carb reload. It happens. You can go a couple of weeks, a couple of months, but at the end of the day, you're gonna feel that that wall hit and you're gonna be like, I need some carbs. The keto master himself, Thomas DeLauer, has stated that.
When I start feeling like my joints are achy, when I start feeling like the pain is kicking in, when I start feeling like I'm getting totally stale, that's when I know it's time to have some carbs again.
That you will feel it when you need a carb reload. So sticking to a complete keto diet isn't a lifestyle that you can continue, you know, without having to change your diet. So I find personally doing a little higher fat, right? Since I'm an athlete, I'm able to consume a little bit more carbs than a keto person would, right? They just roughly stay at 50 grams or less. I play around with maybe 100 to 200 grams of carbs, and I find that a little better. That's me, but I play around. I like to fast. I like to intermittently fast. I like to do circadian rhythm fasting. I like to play with my macros, depends on the day, depends on the activity. Honestly, that's it, but the protein pretty much I like to stick to. So right now I'm on a mass gaining protocol, so I'm on the higher end of the protein, and the fat and carbs I kind of just play around with. But that's it, so that's on you guys. The end ratio is on you, but that's how you're gonna calculate your calories. That's how you're gonna play along with it. That's it. That's it really. So that's how to calculate calories. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give me a like if you can, a dislike if you don't, if you didn't like the video, so I know why, so I know how to change it, so I can provide for you, so you guys can enjoy, learn, experience, and share. All right, it's your boy, that's it, Zach. Punch, headbutt, elbow, knee, peace.